my mom's favorite time. My mom's favorite time. You know, I almost didn't make it today. I had to run errands. You know what I had to do? I had to go and get a physical at the doctor to get insurance to do this show. Did you guys do that?
No, we didn't have to.
You didn't have to? Well, give me a tambourine or something. Because I will never do that again. I don't care. I just have to drop dead. I am not going to any more doctors, man. This cat put on a rubber glove. All right? Put on a rubber glove. I said, Doc, I hope you're getting ready to do an impression of Michael Jackson. You know, do that moonwalk. And I love this. I'll never forget this, right? He said this to me with a straight face, right? He looked at me, he said, bend over. This is going to feel a little uncomfortable. I said, Doc, listen up. New shoes feel a little uncomfortable. That's going to hurt. Then he gave me a cup, right? Said, go in the bathroom and fill this up. I went in there and turned the water on. You should have seen the look on his face when I drank it. You didn't want to test that, did you, Doc? What else? I ran a bunch of errands today. I had to stop off at the bank before they close. I'm scared to use those automated tellers. It looks like you push one wrong button, you're gonna lose your whole life savings. Pac-Man, come through and eat your account. You're broke. It's crazy, man. Now the bank, right, the bank opens at 10 and closes at 3, right? Who goes to work at 11 and gets off at 2? So that means we all have to go back at lunchtime. Everybody in the world is at the bank at lunchtime, except the bank tellers. They're having lunch, right? These people are going, give me my money! That's another thing. If a guy robs a bank, why do they hang his picture in the post office? This guy is hanging out in banks. Hang his picture in the bank with a big sign that says, if you see this man, get the hell out of here. But you know, like rob a bank and then go buy some stamps. Yeah, I like to get about $80,000 worth of stamps. I want to send postcards to all my buddies in prison. The bank is funny. I tell you how funny the bank is, right? I'm in the bank, right? And the door to the vault is standing wide open. But they had the ink pens chained down. And until you pay off your mortgage, the bank owns your house. So I called my banker up, told him to come over and take out his trash. You guys are smoking tonight, and we have a smoking show for you. We have three of the sexiest women in pop music expose. The soulful sounds of James Ingram. And from head of the class, Christine Hodge. We'll be right back. Terry. Carl, what? We don't pay you enough to buy a shirt? What's happening? You can get a shirt.
Oh, man, this is my style here.
That's
you know,
your style.
This is the style here.
And Terry's sitting over there. Terry, now, you know if you go to the doctor, we can get that removed from your head.
This year, I would like that.
Yeah, and Nate sitting back there with a tie. What is that? Did you actually, well, I want to know, I have a question. Did you actually walk into the store and say, that's the tie for me? That's it?
It comes with battery.
Comes with battery. All right. You guys look good and sound great. We have a smoking show for you tonight. This is their new album, What You Don't Know. Three of the hottest women in pop music. Exposé.
I'm not afraid to die.
about cheating on your boyfriend, isn't it?
Yeah. Exactly.
Exactly, well, exactly. You know, cheat on him.
Which you don't know.
The married one in the group. The
I don't know.
That's right, you're married.
Enjoy it. Mm-hmm.
Well, let me see. Let me see. Woo, yeah. That's all right. You did all right.
Married with child.
And I'm not.
You're not.
Neither of us.
That's it. Two. Now, are you two single?
Very single. Single.
Very single.
Very single.
What does very single mean?
It's about as single as you can possibly get.
Well, I see. Well, you know, there's some guys in the band that need a ride home. Why are you very single? I'm sure you must get asked, 20,000 times a month. Let's go out.
Well, it's not as if we're wild women or anything, but we just don't have time.
We tour. We tour all the time. I mean, we are career women. Uh-huh. You know, sometimes guys just don't like that because we're all music.
Uh-huh.
So.
Well, what if he had like a Walkman or something and... Now, one of you likes to sleep in the airport. Which one?
Oh, no. You know, we were on our way to an in-store, which is something, when you go to a store to sign autographs for your fans. And we were waiting and waiting for this flight, and suddenly the flight was ready, and we couldn't find Jeanette anywhere. Ended up, she was laid out on the floor somewhere with her headphones on.
We had just come in from Hawaii, I think it was.
So. Yeah, we were touring.
We were traveling for hours and hours. I was just exhausted, and I had my headset on, and I went, and I kind of lied down across chairs, and... Before you know it, I woke up and everyone was gone.
And we were signing autographs and everybody was, Where's Jeanette?
They just
and
left
they,
you.
They actually left without me. They really did.
Well,
no, they were, well Scott looked for
Joy you. Joy and Ann left without me.
Oh, you were laying on some chairs. That's sad. That's sad.
Well,
that's like a nightmare. You wake up, Mommy! Now, I understand, Ann, I understand you always have to go on your little tour guide.
I am the tour guide of the group. Yes. I mean, I really think it's important that when we come to a city, we should know our audience, we should know what the city's all about. So we go and taste the foods of the city, or we go, like, we had to go to the Alamo because we were in San Antonio. Right. Had to go to the Alamo.
The Alamo.
We went to a museum in Boston, yeah. And, you know, yeah. So we see our fans. Everybody's been to the Alamo. So.
Now, in L.A., where would you go?
In L.A., where did we go? We went to the movies last night.
We went to Universal Studios.
Oh, that's very L.A.
Movies, that's very L.A.
No, but we drive around, we see the sights, because basically L.A. is everything that you see. I mean, when you see the lights at night, that's what it's all about, right?
That's it, L.A. Well, that's everybody. That's Chicago, that's everybody. L.A., the whole works. Now, you guys were moving around out there. Are you dancers, background?
Oh, yeah.
Now we are.
Now you are.
Now we are. Now we're dancers.
I would be scared to dance on stage. You like, you trip, and you just, there's no looking cool after you trip.
Yeah. Well, and it happened. It was an almost fatal incident with Joya here, because we were on stage, and one thing you never do on stage when you're dancing is walk backwards. But Joy decided
she was walking sideways.
You know what? They have those monitors out in front of us, and I was getting so into this song that it was the song Tell Me Why. It's like a strong song for us, and I went walking out, and I tripped over this monitor and flipped backwards. And as I fell down, when I landed, I said, I'm dying! And then the microphone proceeded to fall flat on my head. And Jeanette kind of picked me up.
I saw everything was like slow motion.
Yeah, right. And I just realized watching this mic stand.
Went over and the mic stand fell on her head.
And then just got to stand up.
I almost killed myself. You saw me, I tripped twice today.
Yeah, I saw that. And that's what made me think of that. But I mean, when you trip. I saw you walk over the monitor, and I said, man, I wonder what happens when she's, like, in front of 10,000 people.
But let me tell you something.
I noticed that you, like, filed these down for her. And...
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, but I'm a dancer. I am, really. And when we started out, I was one who danced because my sister is a dancer. She dances on Broadway in Jerome Robbins' play.
Uh-huh.
And so I guess innately, I'm a dancer. I never really took any lessons. But I'm the klutz. I can't figure it out.
Well, you know, well, now you're going to do another number for us later.
Yes.
And you promise not to fall.
I promise.
Okay.
Well, I don't know.
You promise, right?
That's right.
Well, we're going to watch anyway. We'll see. And Joya, Jeanette, expose coming up from head of the class, Christine Hodge. That was great. I like that. You were didn't hurt me. I like that. All right. Please welcome, from head of the class, the gorgeous Christine Hodge. All right. You want a free expose album?
Yes.
Just ask him.
Can I have one?
Sure. Yeah, we'll get
you. Well, there's no record in there. I just hold that. Well, give it. You get it for free from them, but you have to pay me.
We'll get you.
Well, then I'll get it from you.
Get it from me. There you go.
These girls can dance. I'm going to, you're going to give me a few little steps in the back, right?
Sure. You got it.
On the commercial break.
Not from Joya, because she trips. Don't get any steps from that woman. So, it's good to see you.
It's good to see you.
I always see you out. Not that I get out that much, but last time I saw you was at the Mike Tyson fight.
Yes.
Yeah, all 90 seconds of it.
That's right.
That's right.
It was a blast in Atlantic City.
Yes. Now, this is what, the fourth year of Head of the Class?
Yes. We just started. We taped our fourth show of our fourth season just last night.
Ah.
So it's great.
Did you expect it? I mean, did you really, when you did the pilot, did you think, yeah, we have at least 4 years here?
Well, Howard did. Howard said, 4 years, 4 years. And I couldn't believe it. I thought, oh, this is great, this is incredible, but will it really go? I mean, I thought it was a terrific show, but you don't want to count on anything. So
you didn't go spend your money and get crazy?
No, no.
Okay.
Very wise investor.
Oh, there you go.
Yeah.
Now, I have got to pull this out. I was reading the paper, right?
Yes.
And USA Today said that you are going to be married to Prince Albert of Monaco. Am I reading this right?
I haven't seen this.
Oh, well, I'll read it to you.
No.
I'll read it to you. No, wait a second. Now, this is USA Today. I didn't believe it until I saw it in the National Enquirer. Because it's here, too. It's right. Exclusive. She's the next Princess Grace, right? Monaco's Prince Albert proposes to the beautiful Head of the Class star.
Look at that little bow.
With the bow on your head.
A pink bow.
The modern day Cinderella. Not that you were a stepchild or anything. Just tell me this. Just say yes, no, maybe. All right? So, because you don't have to, like, lay everything out. Just say yes, no, maybe. Did you meet him?
So, you know, I have a lot of rabbits.
No.
And I was thinking that's probably your next question.
No,
how
no,
about
no.
all those animals?
No, no, Christine. No, no, no. You got to be, I mean, because, no, this is in USA Today. All right? USA Today.
And today? The guy, was it in Today? This was this
Friday.
Was, oh, Friday.
It was
well,
in
see,
Friday.
So yesterday, really.
All right.
USA.
All right, I tell you what. Now, you have an advice column, right?
Yes.
Okay. What is it, Wow Magazine?
Yes, it's in Wow.
Wow Magazine.
Here well, you did right. some good research.
No, I make it up.
Thanks, Porter.
No, no, you Wow Magazine, and you people write to you and get advice.
Right.
All right, since you don't want to talk about Prince Albert, we all have pictures. What I like to do, I mean, because you know that's exciting, and I know you probably got word and everything from the royal family. Shut up! And, I know what's happening
so
here.
Cute.
No, 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 no. That's okay. Now, let's give advice to one of your fans who would write to Christine and try and
okay.
get advice. Is that cool?
Yeah.
Don't leave me hanging out here
wow
now.
Magazine. Okay.
All right. Now, here we go. You gotta answer this for me, right? Don't leave me hanging, because this is not you answering. This is you giving advice to somebody who would write to you. Correct?
I see.
All right.
Okay.
Dear Christine. I have finally fallen in love with my Prince Charming. But his parents won't let me tell anyone. What should I do?
Boy, that is great.
Go ahead, give it in Wild Magazine. Lay it out.
We're just going to have to pick up your local issue, you know. They'll get upset if I start giving out the information without buying the magazine.
Well, give an answer right here. Tell them, look right into camera, too. Tell them, what would you give advice? The poor girl doesn't know what to do. Prince Charming, go ahead.
Did you see the Ollie North trials?
Uh-huh, go ahead.
Okay, now, can any of you want to be an actress?
Anne wants to be an actress.
Anne, okay, did you see the trials, Anne?
Yeah.
All right, so you asked the question, and this is, you're my counselor.
I'm your counselor.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, so you ask the question, and then you go.
What
okay.
should she do?
I can't make any comment at that time.
She's going to take the fifth. It'll all come out in the wash by November. You could possibly be the next Princess of Monaco. I want to thank you. We'll be right back with the soulful sounds of James Ingram. You left me. Hey, I had this.
for the masterful sounds of James Ingram.
Baby, been gone too long, and I wanna come home. Now I see what you made you mean.
All right, you know everybody, expose, Princess Christine, everybody here. So, this one's hot.
Yeah, thanks.
I was listening to it up in the office. I really enjoy it. You know, you were in a band before. Which group? What was it?
The Revolution Funk.
What is it?
Revolution Funk.
Revolution Funk.
It means the end of the funk.
The end of the funk.
We were the end of the matter.
Oh, okay. You were the last funk to happen.
Right. After the Funkadelics.
After the Funkadelics. Revolution Funk.
Right.
I like that. I think I lost those albums. Did you guys have a record deal?
No. That's a local group.
Oh, it's a local.
That's on our way out here to L.A.
Where are you from originally?
Akron, Ohio.
Oh, Akron. Yeah. They make a few tires there.
Yeah, well, they used to.
Used to?
Yeah, used to be the rubber capital of the world, but now they cheaper labor conditions, you know.
Okay, the whole deal, huh?
Right.
Now, things really started to take off for you when you hooked up with Quincy Jones, right?
Right.
Yeah. How'd that come about?
By way of a publishing company called ATV, singing demos for $50 a song, and they got Just Once to Quincy, peddling him the song.
Just Once?
Right. And he said, who was this singing? So he gave me a call, and here I am.
Nah, man. I mean, that's brilliant. Yes. You gonna do another tune for us?
Love to.
You got it, man. James, Amy. That was fabulous. Look, we're just missing. We'll be back. Performing Natural Man from his new album, It's Real, James Ingram.
Comedian, and now he's a very funny teacher on a new sitcom called Homeroom. Let's take a look.
Well, that was an interesting show. It started off promising, then about mid-lather, a cold front moved in.
Hi, sweetie.
I hope you don't mind if I borrowed your bunny slippers. I can't find mine. They must be mating or something. Speaking of mating, does Bunny Wunny wanna nuggy wuggy?
Not if Bunny Wunny wants to get to med school on time.
You know, Phil, baby talk is hard enough as it is.
Dad was nice enough to come downstairs and fix the plumbing.
Oh, that explains the 40-degree drop in temperature. Always a delightful surprise to the lower half of your body.
Comedian Daryl Savant. All right. All right. You look good.
Thank you. So now you know what Webster's gonna look like when he grows up. You know, I hate when they laugh at stuff like that.
Homeroom.
Homeroom.
Now, what is the deal here? You play a teacher?
I play a fourth grade teacher, and you saw a scene from The Home. You saw Penny Johnson and Bill Cobbs, who play my wife and father-in-law. And I play a fourth grade teacher. We got 25 kids in the class, and it's great.
25 kids. Now, how do you remember their names?
Well, you know, it's easy to remember the black kids' names because black kids have, like, pharmaceutical names. Like, the black family's name, their kids, the whole family's like a pharmaceutical family. It's like, yeah, my name is Advil. This is my wife, Clorette, over here. Tylenol, turn that TV down. You're giving me a headache. It's my oldest daughter, Banaka, and the twins, Murine and Visine. So it's easy to remember the black name.
That's it. Just go down the line.
Yeah.
Now, where are you originally from?
Detroit.
You're from Detroit?
I'm from Detroit.
Oh, man, I'm from Detroit. Did you know? Homeboy.
All right.
Yeah, I lived there until we defected. And no, I love, my family is still in Detroit. I love it.
My family's there. My uncle's there. I got an uncle that's like 80 years old now.
Uh-huh.
He's at the point of his life. He's getting fat and lazy. He's at the point of his life where he just sits in front of the TV, mm-hmm. remote control in his hand. He's looking at my aunt going, Bertha? Bertha? Come in and push the button.
No, man, I loved hanging out in Detroit. I was either at the roller skating rink, running around, or watching TV.
Did you? You know, I find a lot of comics watch a lot of television. Was that true with you?
I, as a kid, I used to love horror movies. Man, I would watch like Psycho and all that stuff. You can't sleep, you know. You watch it as a kid, you can't sleep, but you do things like cover your heads with the sheets in order to sleep. Mm-hmm. Like sheets will protect you from axe murderers. Like a guy can come in the bedroom and go. It's no use. He's under the sheets. No, those are cotton. I can't cut through that. The mummy. I was never afraid of the mummy, though.
No.
No, the mummy was like, you know, he had that walk. He was just, you know, black people, we just thought he was being cool, you know? I was never afraid of the mummy, but I used to love horror films. I'm a horror freak.
Yeah. Uh-huh. Now, this is tremendous. You got your sitcom, making the bank now. You investing the money?
Just bought a dog.
There you go. That's a good investment.
No, I'm usually away, so my girlfriend who I live with, I figured I'd buy a dog for protection, you know, since I'm always gone. I leave her the money. I leave her $1,000. She comes back with a chihuahua. This is my protection, a rat with huge eyes and a nervous condition. When she's not home, he's a football with fur.
A football with fur. He's out of there. Yeah. Now this is the deal. You live with your girlfriend. Yeah. Now, what is that like? I mean, that's tough. I don't know if I could live with my girlfriend.
Well, you know, It's interesting. We're making it, you know.
You're making it. No, I find like, man, you know, I have to take that back. I did for a little while, you know, just for like a week.
Right.
And I find, man, you're like, women, I don't care how much they love you, they will not give up any closet space.
That's true. But you know what? You got to be sensitive. Men have to learn to cry. I cry once a month just to get even with it. She comes home, I'm in the kitchen. With my arms folded, I cry and listen to Aretha Franklin records. When she walks up and asks me what's wrong, I look at her and go, nothing. That's what you gotta do.
This is tremendous, man. I'm sure you're getting a lot of offers, which is nice.
Yeah.
Yeah?
TV show, just got my first commercial.
Yeah. Which one?
Kmart. For this part, and I knew I did a horrible job when I read the script, and the producers called me and said, you got the job. And I said, great, you know, but it was like, they told me, you didn't get the part because you're a great actor, you got it because you got that Kmart look. I mean, that's like something you can be proud of. That's like getting a hemorrhoid commercial because you look like your butt hurts.
You know. Listen, man, I want to thank you for stopping by. We're going to watch you on Homeroom.
Homeroom.
You got it. With 25 kids. And you can only remember the black kid's name. Vicene. All right. We'll be right back. We're going to keep smoking with Exposé.
Don't go away. The Byron Allen Show will be right back.
Christine Hodge from Head of the Class. James Ingram, who's going to go on tour with Patti LaBelle. And from Homeroom, Daryl Savard Davis, spelled backwards. And Exposé, who's going to take us home with Stop, Look, Listen, and Think.
Like the love is gone.
been a Biker production in association with All Britain Television Productions. Night, night.